Welcome, David here, David Lane Design. Talk to you today a little bit about ammo leather and what just is so amazing about it. Wrist check today, I am wearing my Hamilton Chronomatic. Really love the Panda dial. Got a nice thickness, a lot of dial on this watch, which is only 36 millimeters, I believe, and it wears a lot bigger because of that dial. Really cool layout, just kind of the perfect balance almost, especially with that date window at 6 o'clock. I wear it on my Whiskey Butero with rally holes, which I should mention, if you ever want rally holes punched in your strap, just let me know. Happy to do that for you. So wrist check today. Ammo leather. I when I started my business, ammo leather with Panerai was like all the rage. There was a number of makers using vintage leathers to make straps from, really cool design. I own a few of them myself, but I started working with it almost immediately. I bought hundreds of pouches, and I'm not kidding, I have hundreds of these. And I don't typically advertise them only because they are kind of unique and they're difficult to market specifically. So I'm just gonna give you a quick rundown. What I'm gonna show you today is a French ammo pouch. And this one here is what I would consider kind of like a medium to medium dark tan. Just an absolutely beautiful, beautiful leather. Great patina. I mean, you can see the scratches and dents and dings, and that is just the best part about this leather. I mean, just look at the kind of age and patina that this thing has. I mean, it's just absolutely gorgeous. When we make straps from these, we can really make about one strap per side. So we'll use the left side for the buckle end of the strap, the right side for the tail end of the strap, and then the center section ends up becoming the keeper loops. But when we make these, I say they're hard to kind of advertise, not because they're hard to post online, but when you have hundreds of these and they are so completely different, it's hard to photograph one of them and then say, hey, this is all the French leather. All the French leather I have is gonna look like this. Could not be further from the truth. I'm gonna show you right now. You can see just an absolute total difference, and that's not it. This is like a nice matte. You've got some kind of unique sort of watermarks and stains on this one. Here's one that's even more heavily patinaed. This one's stamped 1949, just to give you an idea of the age. I just noticed this, looks like a name is written right along here, which is kind of cool. And then look at the honey tan of this one. I mean, just an absolute dynamite range of vintage browns and tans. I will say, with French leather, it's typically, it's going to be in the tan range rather than brown, but if you are interested at all, these are available on our custom watch strap page. If you go to davidlanedesign.com, click on the custom watch straps, these are an option, and there is a sort of a sample photograph. But if you want something specific, you want something that has a little bit more of that honey brown color to it, or you want something that's a little bit lighter and more matte, just let me know in the order notes and details, and I'll happily send you pictures. If you send me an email ahead of time, I'll happily send you pictures ahead of what you're interested in, or you tell me what you're interested in, I'll send you some pictures. But just keep in mind with these straps and all custom straps, I am literally hand cutting, hand making, and hand stitching them. And especially with the military leathers, they do take a little bit of extra care. We have to soak them. We have to bend them very carefully, or they can crack. Have to skive the leather really carefully because it is old. There is a little bit of obvious pre-wear and tear to them. So it's just a little bit of extra time in making them. But if you've got a vintage Explorer 1, if you've got a vintage Sub, if you've got a vintage anything, these French ammo pouches are some of my favorite. Over the next couple of weeks, I'll be introducing some other ammo leathers. As always, if you have questions, let me know. I am here. I am happy to help, and I really appreciate your feedback. Thank you so much for watching.